Mutualism, biology. Mutualism describes the ecological interaction between two or more species where each species has a net benefit. Mutualism is a common type of ecological interaction. Prominent examples include most vascular plants engaged in mutualistic interactions with mycorrhizae, flowering plants being pollinated by animals, vascular plants being dispersed by animals, and corals with zooxanthellae, among many others. Mutualism can be contrasted with interspecific competition, in which each species experiences reduced fitness and exploitation, or parasitism, in which one species benefits at the expense of the other. Mutualism is often conflated with two other types of ecological phenomena, cooperation and symbiosis. Cooperation refers to increases in fitness through within-species, interspecific, interactions. Symbiosis involves two species living in proximity and may be mutualistic, parasitic, or commensal, so symbiotic relationships are not always mutualistic. Mutualism plays a key part in ecology. For example, mutualistic interactions are vital for terrestrial ecosystem function as more than 48% of land plants rely on mycorrhizal relationships with fungi to provide them with inorganic compounds and trace elements. As another example, the estimate of tropical forest trees with seed dispersal mutualisms with animals ranges from 70 to 90%. In addition, mutualism is thought to have driven the evolution of much of the biological diversity we see, such as flower forms, important for pollination mutualisms, and coevolution between groups of species. However, mutualism has historically received less attention than other interactions such as predation and parasitism. The term mutualism was introduced by Pierre Joseph Van Beneden in his 1876 book Animal Parasites and Messmates. Types. Mutualistic relationships can be thought of as a form of biological barter and mycorrhizal associations between plant roots and fungi, with the plant providing carbohydrates to the fungus in return for primarily phosphate but also nitrogenous compounds. Other examples include Rhizobia bacteria that fix nitrogen for leguminous plants, family Fabaceae, in return for energy containing carbohydrates. Service-resource relationships. Service-resource relationships are common. Three important types are pollination, cleaning symbiosis, and zoochery. In pollination, a plant trades food resources in the form of nectar or pollen for the service of pollen dispersal. Phagophiles feed, resource, on ectoparasites, thereby providing anti-pest service, as in cleaning symbiosis. Elecotinus and Gobiosoma, genera of gobies, feed on ectoparasites of their clients while cleaning them. Zoochery is the dispersal of the seeds of plants by animals. This is similar to pollination in that the plant produces food resources, for example, fleshy fruit, overabundance of seeds, for animals that disperse the seeds, service. Another type is ant protection of aphids, where the aphids trade sugar-rich honeydew, a byproduct of their mode of feeding on plant sap, in return for defense against predators such as ladybugs. Service-service relationships. Strict service-service interactions are very rare, for reasons that are far from clear. One example is the relationship between sea anemones and anemone fish in the family Palmacentridae. The anemones provide the fish with protection from predators, which cannot tolerate the stings of the anemone's tentacles, and the fish defend the anemones against butterflyfish, family Chaetodontidae, which eat anemones. However, in common with many mutualisms, there is more than one aspect to it. In the anemone fish anemone mutualism, waste ammonia from the fish feeds the symbiotic algae that are found in the anemone's tentacles. Therefore, what appears to be a service-service mutualism in fact has a service-resource component. A second example is that of the relationship between some ants in the genus Pseudomyrmex and trees in the genus Acacia, such as the whistling thorn and bullhorn acacia. The ants nest inside the plant's thorns. In exchange for shelter, the ants protect acacias from attack by herbivores, which they frequently eat, introducing the resource component to this service-service relationship, and competition from other plants by trimming back vegetation that would shade the acacia. In addition, another service-resource component is present, as the ants regularly feed on lipid-rich food bodies called Beltian bodies that are on the acacia plant. In the Neotropics, the ant Myrmelocysta schumanni makes its nest in special cavities in Turoya hirsute. Plants in the vicinity that belong to other species are killed with formic acid. This selective gardening can be so aggressive that small areas of the rainforest are dominated by Turoya hirsute. These peculiar patches are known by local people as Devil's Gardens. In some of these relationships, the cost of the ant's protection can be quite expensive. Cordia sp. Trees in the Amazonian rainforest have a kind of partnership with Alimaris sp. Ants, which make their nests in modified leaves. To increase the amount of living space available, the ants will destroy the tree's flower buds. The flowers die and leaves develop instead, providing the ants with more dwellings. Another type of Alimaris sp. Ant lives with the Hertella sp. Tree in the same forests, but in this relationship the tree has turned the tables on the ants. When the tree is ready to produce flowers, the ant abodes on certain branches begin to wither and shrink, forcing the occupants to flee, leaving the tree's flowers to develop free from ant attack. The term species group can be used to describe the manner in which individual organisms group together. In this non-taxonomic context, one can refer to same species groups and mixed species groups. While same species groups are the norm, examples of mixed species groups abound. For example, zebra, Equus birchalli, and wildebeest, Canochetes taurinus, can remain in association during periods of long-distance migration across the Serengeti as a strategy for thwarting predators. Cercopithecus mitis and Cercopithecus ascanius, species of monkey in the Kakamega forest of Kenya, can stay in close proximity and travel along exactly the same routes through the forest for periods of up to 12 hours. These mixed species groups cannot be explained by the coincidence of sharing the same habitat. Rather, they are created by the active behavioral choice of at least one of the species in question. Mathematical modeling. Mathematical treatments of mutualisms, like the study of mutualisms in general, has lagged behind those of predation, or predator-prey, consumer resource, interactions. In models of mutualisms, the terms type I and type II functional responses refer to the linear and saturating relationships, respectively, between benefit provided to an individual of species 1, y-axis, on the density of species 2, x-axis. Type I functional response. One of the simplest frameworks for modeling species interactions is the Lotka-Volterra equations. In this model, the change in population density of the two mutualists is quantified as where mutualism is in essence the logistic growth equation plus mutualistic interaction. The mutualistic interaction term represents the increase in population growth of species 1 as a result of the presence of greater numbers of species 2, and vice versa. As the mutualistic term is always positive, it may lead to unrealistic unbounded growth as it happens with the simple model. So, it is important to include a saturation mechanism to avoid the problem. Type 2 functional response. In 1989, David Hamilton Wright modified the Lotka-Volterra equations by adding a new term, beta mk, to represent a mutualistic relationship. Wright also considered the concept of saturation, which means that with higher densities, there are decreasing benefits of further increases of the mutualist population. Without saturation, species densities would increase indefinitely. Because that isn't possible due to environmental constraints and carrying capacity, a model that includes saturation would be more accurate. Wright's mathematical theory is based on the premise of a simple two-species mutualism model in which the benefits of mutualism become saturated due to limits posed by handling time. Wright defines handling time as the time needed to process a food item, from the initial interaction to the start of a search for new food items, and assumes that processing of food and searching for food are mutually exclusive. Mutualists that display foraging behavior are exposed to the restrictions on handling time. Mutualism can be associated with symbiosis. Handling time interactions. In 1959, C. S. Holling performed his classic disk experiment that assumed the following, that 1. The number of food items captured is proportional to the allotted searching time, and 2. That there is a variable of handling time that exists separately from the notion of search time. He then developed an equation for the type 2 functional response, which showed that the feeding rate is equivalent to where. The equation that incorporates type 2 functional response and mutualism is where, or, equivalently, where. This model is most effectively applied to free-living species that encounter a number of individuals of the mutualist part in the course of their existences. Wright notes that models of biological mutualism tend to be similar qualitatively, in that the featured isoclines generally have a positive decreasing slope, and by and large similar isocline diagrams. Mutualistic interactions are best visualized as positively sloped isoclines, which can be explained by the fact that the saturation of benefits accorded to mutualism or restrictions posed by outside factors contribute to a decreasing slope. The type 2 functional response is visualized as the graph of BAM1 plus ATHM, / display style, / frac, BAM1 plus at sub HM, versus M. Structure of networks. Mutualistic networks made up out of the interaction between plants and pollinators were found to have a similar structure in very different ecosystems on different continents, consisting of entirely different species. The structure of these mutualistic networks may have large consequences for the way in which pollinator communities respond to increasingly harsh conditions and on the community carrying capacity. Mathematical models that examine the consequences of this network structure for the stability of pollinator communities suggest that the specific way in which plant-pollinator networks are organized minimizes competition between pollinators, reduce the spread of indirect effects and thus enhance ecosystem stability and may even lead to strong indirect facilitation between pollinators when conditions are harsh. This means that pollinator species together can survive under harsh conditions. But it also means that pollinator species collapse simultaneously when conditions pass a critical point. This simultaneous collapse occurs because pollinator species depend on each other when surviving under difficult conditions. Such a community-wide collapse, involving many pollinator species, can occur suddenly when increasingly harsh conditions pass a critical point and recovery from such a collapse might not be easy. The improvement in conditions needed for pollinators to recover could be substantially larger than the improvement needed to return to conditions at which the pollinator community collapsed. Humans. Humans are involved in mutualisms with other species. Their gut flora is essential for efficient digestion. Infestations of head lice might have been beneficial for humans by fostering an immune response that helps to reduce the threat of body louse-borne lethal diseases. Some relationships between humans and domesticated animals and plants are to different degrees mutualistic. For example, agricultural varieties of maize provide food for humans and are unable to reproduce without human intervention because the leafy sheath does not fall open, and the seed head, the corn on the cob, does not shatter to scatter the seeds naturally. In traditional agriculture, some plants have mutualists as companion plants, providing each other with shelter, soil fertility and or natural pest control. For example, beans may grow up corn stalks as a trellis, while fixing nitrogen in the soil for the corn, a phenomenon that is used in Three Sisters farming. One researcher has proposed that the key advantage Homo sapiens had over Neanderthals in competing over similar habitats was the former's mutualism with dogs. Evolution of mutualism. Mutualism breakdown. Mutualisms are not static, and can be lost by evolution. Sachs and Sims, 2006, suggest that this can occur via four main pathways. There are many examples of mutualism breakdown. For example, plant lineages inhabiting nutrient-rich environments have evolutionarily abandoned mycorrhizal mutualisms many times independently. Measuring and defining mutualism. Measuring the exact fitness benefit to the individuals in a mutualistic relationship is not always straightforward, particularly when the individuals can receive benefits from a variety of species. For example, most plant-pollinator mutualisms. It is therefore common to categorize mutualisms according to the closeness of the association, using terms such as obligate and facultative. Defining closeness, however, is also problematic. It can refer to mutual dependency, the species cannot live without one another, or the biological intimacy of the relationship in relation to physical closeness, for example. One species living within the tissues of the other species. One species living within the tissues of the other species. One species living